This is ZNS Total Sports, brought to you by 4th Terrace Diagnostic Center.
Good evening, Bahamas. I'm Kelsey Johnson. Welcome to Sports Friday. The countdown is on for the hosting of the second annual Popeyes Bahamas Bowl. Kickoff is at noon on Christmas Eve at the Thomas A. Robinson National Stadium. The two teams meeting on the gridiron are Middle Tennessee Blue Raiders and Western Michigan Broncos. The event, which was up for a major sporting award last year, have organizers overly confident that this year's game will be a thriller.
I know the game's going to be great. I know Western Michigan and Middle Tennessee are going to just bring a high level of football, caliber football, to our bowl game, and just really looking forward to a great week.
But this game that we look forward to on Christmas Eve is a special time for the Bahamas. Christmas in the Bahamas is like Christmas nowhere else in the world. And for us to take a whole day off to celebrate football, college football, is a great time for all of us. And that shows how important this game is to the Bahamas.
Minister of Tourism Obi Wilchcombe said the new partnerships forged through sporting activities has resulted in major investments in the country. Wilchcombe noted that the Popeyes Bahamas Bowl is just one of many relationships that started since they initiated the new sports tourism brand.
The Popeyes event, which will take place in a couple of weeks, of course, we made it to the finals of the ESPY Awards. Now we have the restaurants open here, and one's going to open also in Grand Bahama. Again, it's all about going networking. It's about causing for these major brands to come to the Bahamas and to want to be a part of. You heard Bubba Watson say, "I want now a house in the Bahamas." That's what happens, a spillover effect, and we're going to see more and more of that.
A number of coaches are speaking out after the Father Marcy and Peters basketball tournament was canceled. Longtime coach of the HO National Lions junior girls, Patricia Patty Johnson, said she found out when she took her squad to the gym to play. This was also the case for head coach of the Harbor Island team.
First of all, it's a shocker to me, and I wasn't notified. I don't know anything about it. But you know, like I always say, as many games as the kids can play is a good thing. And as many of them can play basketball or any other sport, it's a good thing to keep them out of problems. Because with all these things going right on now in the Bahamas, we need more activities for the children.
I've been coming from 1996. This is the first time we come to this tournament and we haven't played in Father Marcy. And I don't think it's right. Nobody even told us anything. We just decided to come to a tournament. And whatever going on with the Ministry of Sports, they need to get it together, because I've been around basketball for quite some time, and you know that. But to see what's going on now, and all these kids now want to play basketball, it's a slap in the face to the kids. It's a slap in the face.
The decision to cancel the annual tournament was made because of financial reasons. This according to Michael Scooter Reed, tournament organizer. Reed, too, said he is disappointed about the cancellation.
I really wasn't sure, you know, but I did all the work. I put it together, and I was told that we wouldn't be having it this year for financial reasons. But I'm not sure of the real reason, but... You know, I was disappointed, but, you know, and I know the kids are disappointed, the Family Island kids, you know, because my first idea after the hurricane was to cancel it, because the hurricane, and if we play and they sit down there while they're suffering, we may be sending the wrong message. But then the Family Island ones came to me and said, "Nobody, we need something to rebound on." And so I went after it, and apparently I went after it too late, and they had already resolved the funds, so, you know. That's how it goes, you know. Things got to work.
There's always a familiar face behind the clipboard inside the huddle during a timeout in a women's basketball game. That face, in this case, is Anthony Swaby, a name well recognized by players and those sitting in the stands.
I came back from school and I saw where the talent here could be used for getting young ladies scholarships and colleges and high school. But the fundamental level of play I was not happy with, so I decided to form my own club, known then as the Invincible Angels. And out of that program, came some of the best young ladies that played basketball in this country. We were fortunate enough to be sponsored at one time, I think, by one of the best sponsors of that time, Mr. Sidney Butts outing, and we became known as the Burger King Angels. At one time, we had persons such as Kim Roll, Felice Cartwright, Varell Clark, who is now Varell Clark Davis, Charlene Smith, just to name a few. Ladies, if I forget anyone, forgive me. But we went 4 years without losing a game. We finally lost in the championship to Patty and her team. But we've always been successful for the simple reason we've been able to send young ladies off to school, and they came and they were good enough to come home and represent the team.
Swaby said the game hasn't changed that much. It's the players' approach to the game that contributes to the results that you now see happen on the regional and international levels.
During those days, I would call practice. Number one, they would get there before me. We would end practice and no one wanted to go home. And I think during those days, we just worked harder than anyone else. And they saw the benefits of what they could get out of being a part of the club. During those days, we traveled all summer. And one of the things was, you must get your grades. There's no sense coming here and hoping that I could get you into school if you didn't have grades. At some time, the schools where these young ladies went thought I was their parents. I used to be up there so often. And it wasn't like today where you could go online and check young ladies' stats and everything else. You know, so it took hard work, but in the long run, most of them, even up to today, show gratitude for what they got from the program.
According to Swaby, all of his players were special. They all had a unique approach to the game.
We were fortunate. We were the only team to have a Miss Bahamas, and in the form of Miss Fontella Dean Chipman, and she continues to come out and be a part of the program. Leslie Miller was another beauty queen that played. So, you know, there was a mixture of persons. We have had beauty and talent within this club. All we ask the girls is to come out and work hard.
Well, that's all the time we have for sports. Once again, I'm Kelsey Johnson.